everyone, I'm at the booth centre again. It's Amanda here, and welcome to the live stream. As you can see in the background here, we're having some painting done. So we're getting the centre ready for when we can reopen again. But that's not going to be until much later in the summer, depending how things go. So in the meantime, remember we've got emergency advice and support in our garden between 9 and 12 Monday to Friday. And otherwise, reply to the text messages for free. Pick up the phone when we phone you to have a chat, and keep doing the things in the activity packs, and keep tuning into this live stream because we really want to keep in touch. Stay busy, take your exercise outside, but keep yourself safe and make sure you're spending lots of time at home looking after yourselves. And see you all soon. I'll hand over to Thom.
Thank you, Amanda, and good morning, everybody at home. Hope you're all keeping well, hope you're all staying safe, washing your hands and all that jazz. I have been doing, but I've also been keeping busy with my Connection Through Activities pack. As you all know, that's the aim of the game this week, isn't it? Whipping through these, keeping ourselves busy, etc. So, I like to start at the top. Got a bit of art usually, don't we? So, I've actually done it. I've actually gone ahead and I've had a good old go at the watercolours. So, you may have seen me doing all sorts of different pieces with the pencils and the felt tips and stuff like that, but I've been avoiding these, been giving them a bit of a wide berth, haven't I? Because, to be honest, a little bit intimidated by them. Never really used them before, didn't know what I was doing. So, and it was sort of, it was one of those things, every time I looked it up online, it was always someone dead professional, and like they've got really expensive paints, they've got really expensive paper and brushes and 1,000 different types of brushes, and we've only got one, maybe two or something like that. So I've always been a little bit put off by it, but I thought, you know what, we've got to do it. Got to learn somehow, so got to start at the bottom. So I found, tried to find like the simplest video as I possibly could, and I just copied it really. Well, I say copied it. I've drawn my own picture, but I've used their techniques. There was lots of little bits and surprising things that caught me off guard. Which I'll probably, yeah, I'll cover in a minute when I start the time lapse. But there's one thing that I can tell you about watercolour, and that was amazing for me, is how relaxing it was. It's like, I like colouring in anyway, felt tips and all that stuff, but doing this watercolouring, I don't know if it was the video that I was watching, or the music they were using or something like that, but I went into like a dream zen zone. It was amazing. I was gutted when the video finished. It had like that sort of like, if anybody knows what ASMR is, it's like it's one of those things, it's the sort of thing you put on to relax yourself. It's just like noises and swooshes, or it could be images, or like people playing with things and tapping and like crunching, all that sort of stuff. So yes, audio stimulus, something or other, that's what it stands, that's what ASMR stands for anyway. So yeah, I found it very much like watching one of those ASMR YouTube channels or something like that. So, gotta recommend it really. It was really, really good fun. So yeah, let me have a look. And as I was going, I did tweak things and change things, but as I was watching the video, because I was learning as I was going. So I'll just show you what I learned. So, starting at the top. Oh yeah, so they all seem to tape their pages to the floor, to the table, sorry. And look at that, I'm already having a mistake there. So it doesn't really focus. I'll show you at the end, but I tried to take my tape off, it's already started ripping. So I'm doing something wrong there to start with, so I was like, right, I'm not doing that. How are they sticking their tape to the paper without the paper ripping? There is a hack to it. Got my tape. I mean, you don't have to do this tape thing. This is just for me, so I can give a neat border and I can keep it in place so it doesn't move from where the camera's pointing at. Because that's one of my problems, is I keep shifting the paper all over the camera and you can't see it properly. So yeah, see what I'm doing there? I'm losing some of the tackiness off the tape just by sticking it on something furry. So I don't want it dead sticky, so I don't want it to rip my page when I pull it off. So yeah, stick it on your arm or on your jacket, wherever my jacket's gone, and when you pull it off, it takes some of the fibres off with it and makes it a little bit less sticky. Come on, focus, camera. Oh yeah, you can focus now. You can see, yeah, I also had a little doggo hair. So thank you very much for that, Pike. Try and do neat things and I can't because I've got a scruffy little dog running around. Anyway, yeah, so catch up from there, speed up from there, put all the sides on. You'll see what it looks like at the end when I pull the tape off, why I do that. So one of the things they always do is they just put loads of water on the paper to start with. I say, I don't mean loads, I don't mean like turn the tap on it, but you saw me then. I just went over it with the brush, the whole page, spreading water across it like you would be paint. Because look what it's doing to that blue. I started with a bit of blue at the top, and then as I dragged it down, it whooshed into the water. I love the way that that blue and that yellow were blending together. I thought that was really nice. So yeah, in my head, I've got an image that I'm going for. So yeah, I started with the sky, faded down to a bit of a sunset, and then that grey horizon that I've done, that is something you may recognise, and then a green underneath it. Let's see where we go from here. And then just sort of a yellowy again down the bottom. So I've done the background colours. This is the way that they all seem to start on these videos, is they do a layer, and then they add to it. So what I did there was waited for a little bit, and then came back and then drawing these extra details on. So this is sort of like the background of what I'm going to be doing. I'm doing a yellow because it's the same colour as the section of the fade that I'm in. And I'm going to go back over it and draw things on top of that. But yeah, you can see here I'm getting some details in the bottom. You may start to see what things are. But that little like box, the green box on the left hand side, those square lines around it, you can see very unsubtle, aren't they? So what I did in a moment, I think, you just get a bit more water on your brush and rub it over that, and it all blends together, same as what I've just done at the bottom. I just spotted some different random colours in, and then went back with the water and just mashed it all together, and it just blends. And less focus in watercolouring, I think, is the way to go, really. I think that big dirty brown block in the middle there, I don't know why I did that, but then you know what you do? You add some water to it, and then I just washed it out, didn't I? So yeah, smooshed it around a bit, and it looks much nicer. There's a little garden table in there, we've got some flowers in there, we've got a little greenhouse, we've got a cityscape in the background, we've got green panel fences. Anybody recognise where it might be? And so yes, what I did here, I took all my tape off, gives it a nice border, doesn't it? But then I hated that bit, that it didn't go behind the tree. So what did I do? You just rewash it. And then, so I spread the brown behind it and then put the green back in front. Perfect, I love watercolours now. It was dead fun, really, really good fun. And yeah, I did my best joined up handwriting, not done that since I was like 12 at school. But no, I was very impressed with how I did there. I did not expect to do so well. So yeah, you can see I put like little tires on the wall. So I did this all from brain, all from memory. And I think it succeeded. I think I did a good job there. I think I will be doing some more watercolours. Look how cool that is. I'm dead happy with my first proper watercolour. Really chuffed with that. This card is better to use than normal A4 paper. Normal A4 paper does just wrinkle up and doesn't absorb the paper as much. You can see this one sort of curved a little bit. That's because watercolour paper is actually a lot thicker than even than this card, and it's built to take the amount of water, and then it dries off and then it's ready afterwards. It's not going to always stay wet. But yeah, I'm dead happy with that, and I think that looks fairly reasonably like the Booth Centre Garden-ish. So where the sort of the angle that I'm thinking of that this is taken from, if you walk down into the back garden, down a little slope, and then stop at the bottom of the slope, then that is the view that you're getting. That's what I think, anyway. That's what, in my mind, it looks like, anyway. There we go. Another 25th celebration drawing for you. So, get your postcards out. Give it a bit of a draw. If you've got watercolours, have a go at the watercolours. I would love to see what everybody else is doing. And also, remember, I was going to say the best bit. It's not the best bit, but it's a good bit. We're doing a 25 quid giveaway, aren't we, this week? It's the £25 because it's the 25th anniversary. We normally do £10 every week, this week, 25. So, more incentive there for you guys to send these postcards back to us and we'll get them on the wall. There's a few over here. I have also heard that tomorrow I can announce who has won the rainbow competition. Which means you can also, there is still time to get your bumblebee one in. And what was the other one? I can't even remember. Whatever they were, you still got time to get the other ones in. So you can get them all in still. You could still be the winner for that week. You could send them all at once. You could be the winner for this week. In fairness' sake, we probably won't do the same person winning every week. But if you send one in for every week, you've got a chance of winning. So there you go. worth doing, isn't it? Right, where are we going from there? So we've done our watercolour in. That means I think I should take us over to the corner of the activities room in the booth centre and see Richard. He's been leaving us riddles, hasn't he? And yesterday he set us the one. He's full of keys, but can't even open a door. So I was thinking, like, does it mean it's like the container? So I was thinking, is it full of keys, as in, like, is it a bag of keys and the bag can't open the door or any door? I don't know. I'm confusing myself now because he twists my brain, Richard does. But see if he can straighten it out this time and then retwist it with a new riddle.
Yesterday's riddle, I think I almost gave the answer, really, or gave you a clue. I'm full of keys but can't open any door. Well, I'm not an ordinary key, if you like, that opens doors. I'm a piano, or maybe a keyboard. Okay. Are you getting the hang of these riddles? I think probably you are. Let's hope so. What kind of coat can only be put on when wet? Think about it. How could that be possible? A coat you could only put on when it's wet.
Yeah, one that I can actually get. Oh, finally, eh? I've been messing around, trying to figure out some of these other ones. But yes, finally, one that I know. Or, well, and it's not even one that I've heard before. I've just figured it out with my own sense. So, yeah. I'm catching up maybe to some of the guys. Some of you guys seem to know it every day. Don't know if it's just wisdom or something like that, but you know a lot more than I do, but not today. I've got this one pinned. I'll be so angry tomorrow if I'm wrong though. I'm not gonna say what it is, obviously, because it's for you guys to guess as well. Right, so as I said before, it is the 25th anniversary this week. That is what we are celebrating. So, in our little art packs, there is a page, page 7 it is, we have Tony's lemon cheesecake recipe. So, I've been talking about it all week, said I was going to do it. I've only gone and done it, haven't I? So, let's have a run over to my computer and I shall start me in the kitchen.
Good morning, gang, how we all doing? So yeah, we're back in my kitchen, as you can see. Got my two cameras set up. You're not supposed to be able to see the second camera, are you? If you're as a proper videographer, you ain't supposed to see that. So you guys just ignore that that's there and pretend that it's like out of shot and like the TV. So, got a simple one for us today because it's the 25th anniversary of the Booth Centre. We thought we'd better make something cake based. And we thought, you know what? Tony's got a couple of ideas. You may have seen Tony around the centre. Sometimes helping in the kitchen, the minute he's helping out doing the art packs and stuff like that. But yeah, he chipped in and said he knows how to make a simple lemon cheesecake. And it only has a little bit of microwaving involved, you know. So, let's see what we've got up to then. Right, so, I've got all my ingredients down here. I've got my margarine. I've got biscuits. It says it's ginger nuts, but it doesn't have to be ginger nuts. It just says whatever your choice is. Lemon juice, got that left over from pancake day. Philadelphia cheese, you don't have to buy the brand stuff. I was very late and slow and went to the local corner shop and bought it for full price rather than buying it from an Asda or something like that. All of these stuff, better off buying it from a big shop, aren't you? Otherwise you're just going to be wasting your money if you go to a local shop. I mean, they're good for your bits and bobs, but they're ripping you off at the end of the day. They've got to make their money, haven't they? So yeah, here's my stuff over it, and a bit of sugar. It's optional to taste. I mean, optional, but yeah, I'm going to be using it. Don't you worry about that. And then fruits of choice, so raspberry, blueberries, blackberries, whatever goes normally in a lemon cheesecake. Anything that you fancy. I've not got anything at the moment, but I've noticed later on in the instructions here that there is the bit where we have to refrigerate it for a couple of hours. So maybe when we're refrigerating the actual cake itself, I can go and grab some fruits of some sort. But anyway, what we're doing, first of all, crush up the biscuits in a bowl. Oh yeah. Got a little visitor down here, can you see him yet? Hey, come here, Pike. Come here. Hey, here he is. Come in to see. Probably could have, you can smell that. I've got the Philadelphia out. But he's a dog, of course he wants cheese. Make sure you wash your hands constantly. Obviously, I wash my hands again now because I touched the doggo. I mean, I might love him, but he's definitely a stinky boy. Back to the crushing of the biscuits. I'm sure there is a better way of doing it than I'm doing it, but nobody told me, so. Back to crushing it with my spoon, I suppose. Right, I got fed up with trying to crush them biscuits with a spoon, so I did a bit of research, and the best way you can do it, put it in something and then smash it. So I've got a new clean bag, I'm gonna put my biscuits into the bag, and then I'm gonna smash the bag. Right, I think I've got all the majority of the chunks out of it now. So, let's see. But it's been a long time doing that there. I'll probably, after I've done all this, I'll Google it, figure out what the best way of crushing biscuits is, or the fastest way of crushing biscuits, and I'll tell you after I've done this section. So that'll be future Thom will tell you the tip on how to crush these biscuits, if there is a tip. Microwave the butter. I'm a greedy so-and-so, so two tablespoons, probably something like that, I'm not quite sure. What do you reckon? That looks like it'll mix into that. Into the microwave for just 30 seconds. This is the only bit of cooking we need to do on this one. Ooh. So, that was probably sizzling by the end, you can still hear it. Bubbling away in there. That's what we've got to do first. Ooh, yeah. Butter and biscuits, as if biscuits weren't good enough on their own. And that's probably nicely mixed in, making a bit of a mess there, but whatever. And put the mixture into a plastic takeaway tray. I have a plastic takeaway tray here, can you see? Put the mixture into there. Created a base, can we see there? So, nice little base. What next? Tony. Mix the Philadelphia and lemon juice. So I'll use the same bowl as before. We'll have the rest, please. So let's get some optional sugar in it. Just to taste. So you know what that means for me? That just means a bit of a glug. It's already going to be fairly sweet because of the ginger nuts. So don't want to put a hell of a much more in. Bit of lemon juice. How much was it? 2 teaspoons. So I've got about a teaspoon here. You do your one. I'll do your two. Right. Got to do now. Stick it on top of the biscuits. Stick it in the fridge for a couple of hours. Mmm. Mmm. The topping tastes good. Right, so, as you can see, it's starting to look like a cheesecake now, isn't it? See the base, see the cheesy top. Right, all I've got to do now, stick it in the fridge for a couple of hours, and if you want, get some fruit ready, that sort of thing, to stick on top. I might not, it tastes all right, you know? We'll see, what I feel like in a couple of hours. Right, it's been a couple of hours. I didn't go to the shops, so I didn't get any proper fruit, but I had to dig around in the cupboards and I found some old, well, I say old, I've got some dried apricots. They're not that old, they're just dried apricots. So I'm gonna decorate it with my dried apricots. So let's have a do that quickly. Here it is, looking pretty good. See, look. Ooh, it's not falling out or anything. How cool is that? It looks like a proper cheesecake now. Cool, right, let's do a little bit of chopping. Just get my knife. So I've only got a few apricots left, as you can see. Get them out, give them a chop. Because I want to decorate it nicely. I want to put some, maybe some writing on it or something. So I'll chop it into long, thin bits so I can use it as a writing or a text of some sort. So yeah, just little slivers like that. Feel like extra bits, get them eaten.
Good for you.
Lovely, right, I'm not gonna be here. Gonna go back into the studio. Eat it over there, so see you in a second.
Right, all that was a bit of fun, wasn't it? So yeah, I do. I have it right here. Smells good, smell the lemoniness to it. Nice little touch. I've always thought, like, I think the thing that put me off when I was younger about cheesecake, I was like, cheese in cake? Nah, but I've grown up and now understand cheesecake. What else can I do but dig in? I can't imagine it's going to be like one that you get from the shops or something like that, you know, where the base is solid and the cheese sits on it properly and you can slice it. I don't think that's going to happen. I feel like the biscuit base may be a little loose. Well, it's not rattling or anything. It might just be a matter of eating it straight from here. I don't think I could take a slice out of there, could you? Right. Gonna do it. Don't know if it's wise eating it on camera like this, but let's dig in. I'll see if I can get like a piece from it. Yeah, not looking too bad. It's actually cutting. So far, so good. Let's see if we can get a chunk. Oh no, yeah, the biscuit base is crumbly like I expected. But that looks like cheesecake, doesn't it? Oh come on, go and focus it. Focus, not on my face, focus on the cheesecake. My camera doesn't like focusing on cheesecakes, it likes focusing on faces. Here we go. Yes. I'm gonna eat all of that today. Oh, that's really good. You know, I was putting myself down saying, oh, it's not gonna be as good as the shops. That is better than the shops. Much better than the shops. Oh, Tony, what a recipe. Brilliant, mate. Brilliant. I don't know why everybody doesn't make their own. Well, I was like, it took me like 10 minutes, something like that. 2 hours of sticking it in the fridge. Boom, you've got an amazing cheesecake. And yeah, probably in total, it cost like 4 or 5 quid, something like that, for all of the ingredients. But I've still got half a packet of biscuits left. Still got 99% of the sugar left. Still got all that lemon juice left. And yeah, and still some Philadelphia left, so I could still have a sandwich later. So yeah, I don't think that's bad. And it's a celebration, isn't it? We've got to treat yourselves and, yeah, just keeping yourselves busy, all that. So, lovely, that'll do me a few days. I mean, I say I'm going to eat it all now, but I'd be very greedy if I ate all of that today, wouldn't I? Probably be sick. But anyway, what have we got next? Oh yeah, perfect. You know what I've just done? I've just lined lined my throat with a nice amount of Philadelphia cheese. You know what that means? It's perfect time to get them vocal cords going, doesn't it? Now they're all greased up and claggy. So yeah, if I do a bit of spitting in these next few songs, it's not my fault, it's the cheesecake's fault. Right, yeah, we've got a couple of bangers, proper bangers today. Both from the Booth Centre songbook. So let's have a look at what we've got. We've got a young gentleman. I love it when somebody comes in on a piano, which is what we've got today, so here we go. Can you tell what it is yet? You will know it.
Thank you for coming home. I'm sorry that the chairs are all worn. I left them here, I could have sworn. These are my salad days, slowly being eaten away. Just another play for today. Oh, but I'm proud of you. I'm so proud of you. Nothing left to make me feel small. Look, has left me standing so tall. Soul, you've got the power to know, 'cause you're indestructible. always believe it, 'cause you are gold. I'm glad that you're bound to return. There's something that I could have learned, 'cause you're indestructible. Always believe in
cheesecake.
After the rush has gone, I hope you find a little more time. Remember, we were partners in crime. It's only 2 years ago, the man with the suit and the case. You knew that he was there on the case, and now he's in love with you. He's in love with you. My love is like a high prison wall, but you can leave me standing so tall. Gold, always believe in your soul. You've got the power to know, 'cause you're indestructible. Always believe in it, because you are gold. I'm glad that you're bound to return. Something that I could have learned, 'cause you're indestructible. Always believe it. My love is like a high prison wall, but you can leave me standing so tall. You're indestructible. Always believe it, 'cause you are gold. I'm glad that you're bound to return. Something that I could have learned, 'cause you're indestructible. Always believe it.
Yes! Oh, what a banger! Yeah, man! Love Spandau Ballet. Classic band. What was they? 80s? 70s? 80s? I don't know. A little bit before my time, but you know me. I like my oldies. I've done my research. I've listened to all the classics. But yeah, 70s, 80s, I'm going to say. I'm not 100% sure. Apologies to anyone who knows. Right. Another one. Here we go. Right, so I know that the Rolling Stones, they were like 60s and 70s, weren't they? They were skirting that boundary. So yes, we've got one here, Paint It Black. Our guys done a nice black and white video for us. Keep it moody, you know? He's Paint It Black after all, isn't it? Drums. Drums are amazing in this song in real life, aren't they? Chum, 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 chum.
I see a red door and I want to paint it black. No colours anymore, I want them to turn black. I see the girls walk by, dressed in their summer clothes. I have to turn my head until my darkness goes. I see a line of cars and they're all painted black, with flowers and my love both never to come back. I see them turn their heads and quickly look away, like a newborn baby, it just happens every day. I look inside myself and see my heart turn black. I see my red door and must have it painted black. Maybe then I'll fade away and not have to face the facts. It's not easy wasting one way your whole world is black. No more will my green seagulls sit into deeper blue. I could not foresee this thing happening to you. If I look hard enough into the setting sun, my love will laugh with me before the morning comes. I see a red door and I want to paint it black. No colors anymore, I want them to turn black. I see the girls walk by dressed in their summer clothes. I have to turn my head until the darkness grows.
Yes, buddy! The Rolling Stones, classics, again from the Booth Centre Archives. What a lovely episode that was. I've had a great time, thank you very much for joining us all. Yeah, we've had the watercolours, very happy with that. Chuffed with myself, very chuffed with myself. I would like to see if you guys can get on board. Do yourselves a little bit of watercolour, see what it turns out like. Then we've got some coming up tomorrow that I will be able to show you from our postcard competition. And remember, I will be announcing winners. So, make sure you tune in. Could be your lucky day. Right, thank you very much. I'm going to go and eat my lemon cheesecake and plan for tomorrow, I think. Friday, end of the week. Got to make it special, haven't you? So, yeah, look forward to seeing you then. Thank you very much. Keep safe. Keep washing your hands. Keep connected. I've been Thom. See ya.